Hello, everybody. I am Miles. I am the universe. Today, I wanted to talk about fear. The reason why I wanted to talk about fear is because we live in a very uneasy manner. We are very fearful, even though most of us probably don't realize the extent of our fear. So with this video, I want us to start to tackle fear as our baseline. How do we move out of a lower vibration, which is fear? Fear can control us, can dictate our every decision without us even realizing. How do we move out of fear and into something better? Okay, this is just a starting point to dissolve a little bit of fear. How do we do that? Well, in order for us to defeat our enemy, we must first understand what our enemy is. Fear is a survival instinct. It has been genetically by our side throughout human history and evolution to maintain our species, okay? When we were cave people and there was a lion chasing us, ready to kill us, okay? We developed adrenaline and other neurotransmitters to make sure we escaped. Or we killed the thing that was killing us, okay? Fight or flight. Fear is the biological response to danger, and it causes us to either fight the problem or run away from the problem. So we know then that fear is as old as human history, okay? But we know that it was developed as a survival instinct to danger. Nowadays, in human lives, even though we still very much hold on to fear, the danger is no longer quite as prevalent, okay? It's probably, we misinterpret signals from our environment, such as, you know, job security or money or relationships or friendships or anything like that. We interpret those as danger now because, you know, our livelihoods is as much as our lives, you know, our surroundings, our status, who we think we are, is just as important to us as our very lives. So we interpret things as gonna kill us because in our minds, those things probably could kill us, you know, in our minds. So the fact that we're here talking today is probably because someone in our ancestry was very, very scared at one point and ran away, yeah? So we have to be grateful for fear. We have to, you know, respect its awesome power. We have to respect the fact that it's probably kept it's kept humans alive, okay? So we very much depend and should respect fear. It's not something to be frightened of itself. It's something to be revered and respected and understood. So understanding that it's helped us, we also though need to understand that fear gets in the way of our day-to-day lives. Fear in a survival situation, when we're anxious and we're worried about something, our body is slowly releasing adrenaline and things like that. And when we have an influx of adrenaline, we also, to balance it out, have an influx of cortisol, the stress hormone. And when we have too much fear, we have too much adrenaline, and ergo, we have too much cortisol. Cortisol, on a physical level, okay, what it does to the human body is horrible. The damage that it does to a human body is terrible, okay? Easily shorten our lifespans, that's a given. But on a physical level, you know, our hair will start to fall out or turn grey, you know, stress. We'll have big bags under our eyes. Our metabolisms will either be too fast or too slow, meaning we'll either put on too much weight or we won't be able to put weight on at all or lose weight. We will approach lives with distress and unease and you know, dissatisfaction, because our base level, we have too much stress, too much cortisol. We will begin to associate life with pain because we live in a state of unease, dis-ease. So what I'm trying to say is, even though fear is important to our past, moving forward into the future, okay, we have to learn to put fear to the side. discernment and logic and higher vibration is going to serve us more than, you know, something we had to suffer as animals. Okay, when we were on par with animals, learning how to use tools and things, we had to use our animal instincts. Okay, we don't need to use it anymore. Or at least we have to learn how to harness fear and point it in the correct direction. How can we use fear to take us higher rather than take us lower? Okay. So fear in today's sense is the inability to cope with uncertainty. So our worries, anxieties, fears, everything that, you know, we're not quite sure of comes from fear, and it's because we're uncertain about the outcome, or we're uncertain about how we're going to be perceived in a scenario, or we're uncertain about the outcome of a situation, how it's going to affect us. For us to tackle fear, we have to understand that fear is our friend, okay? Uncertainty is our friend, yeah? With a lot of things, when it comes to mental health and things like that, or spiritual well-being, a lot of it is paradoxical. A lot of it says one thing and you think, but it's actually backwards. Yeah, it's actually like back to front. So if you think then, what I'm saying is it's back to front, what I'm going to say next is going to be paradoxical, yeah? What we fear, we attract. If you imagine that you fear social interaction, okay? You fear it so much that you will avoid seeing your friends, or even you might not even have friends. You'll avoid seeing your family. You will avoid going to the shop. You'll avoid leaving your house because you're afraid of social interaction, yeah? Because you spend so much time avoiding something, you know exactly where to find it. You know exactly where your fear lies because you spend so much time obsessed with it, yeah? And I know this because I have been extraordinarily anxious myself for a very long time, and I am overcoming my fear daily. I am practicing what I'm talking to you about. So I know it's difficult, I really do. When we learn to focus on the thing we're most scared of, we can only think of that terrifying thing, yeah? And therefore, we will attract scenarios within which we will be terrified. If you imagine as well that, you know, worries about money or relationships or status or, you know, whatever it is, you have worries about something, you spend your day-to-day life obsessed with the thing you're worried about, it will become the biggest thing in your mind, and you will live in a state of panic and dismay because it would be the only thing on your mind because you're terrified of it. So with all this being said then, if we want to overcome our fear in life, we must learn to embrace fear as our friend, yeah? We must learn that we are not going to get rid of fear by avoiding it. We're never going to overcome our anxieties, our stress, our woes by running away from it, okay? Because it will always follow us, because it'd be all we can, you know, we're trying to avoid it. And like I said, if you're trying to avoid something, you know where to step, yeah? You know where the obstacle is. You will see it, yeah? You'll focus on it. Therefore, you need to move the obstacle. You need to clear away. You need to do something about the thing that you fear. And that takes courage, okay? Takes a hell of a lot of courage to overcome fear, okay? I'm not saying it's going to be easy. I'm not saying it's enjoyable. But I'm saying once you learn that fear can't be avoided, okay? Fear, if it dictates your life, then if you want to get over fear, you have to be courageous. You have to tackle the thing that you're scared of. And the only way on this planet, okay, there's no drug, there's no pill you can take to create courage. Courage, real, legitimate courage, comes from and only from facing your fear. Again, we have to then, okay, for us to, we have to flip it. For us to overcome fear, paradoxically, we have to like chase after fear. We have to go towards fear. We have to do the things that terrify us the most. This is quite a difficult concept to grasp, I understand, but fear is probably our best motivator, our best guiding light, because the things we fear probably are the things that if we worked on, our lives would improve, yeah? If we were able to deal with the things in our life that terrified us with courage, we would overcome any obstacle easily. Because we've always seeking out fear, we're always unearthing the roots of pain. And we're doing it with courage and bravery and strength, so that any obstacle that comes in our way, we tackle it with courage and wisdom. So the goal is basically to build courage. As a rule of thumb, right? So it, you know, maybe in future videos I will help tackle, you know, minor things or start you on a journey, but as a general rule, okay, fear can only be conquered with courage. And you can only generate courage by going at the thing you fear. You know, unfortunately, there is no easy way to tackle fear without facing it. A little bit of help then as well is we kind of reimagine fear as almost like a little bell of awareness. When something crops into our mind, you know, doubt or worry, social anxiety, you know, things like that, we can learn over time with meditation as well. Don't forget, you've got to start doing that. We can begin to reimagine fear as a ding dong, that thing is bugging me. Subconsciously, that thing is bugging me. If I go and sort it out, it's going to stop bugging me, and I can refocus on the things that's going to get me on my path, on my journey. Yeah, fear is just an obstacle. Fear, just think of it like that. Who cares? Who cares? Who cares? Who cares? Yeah, that thing's pissing me off. Yeah, I was scared of it. I'm fearful of it. But if I just go, it's probably smaller than I thought it was. You know, it's like a little carrot. Smaller. It's like less impactful. And I can just, it nourishes me because I've dealt with it. And I'm back on my journey. Yeah. Courage then as well. Okay, this is another, you know, thing. If we imagine then that fear is fight or flight, okay? Fight or flight doesn't mean kill the thing. It doesn't mean run away from it. Can, you know, fight can be excessive control, exerting your control and your anger onto a situation, projecting your fear onto a situation in an attempt to control it. Okay, that is uncertainty. Okay, we are fearing an outcome that is uncertain, and we attempt to control it. Okay, that isn't what I'm talking about when I say tackle a problem. Okay, in this instance, when our instinct is to fight the problem that we're scared of, okay, sometimes relinquishing control is courageous. Let's say, for example, to make this make sense, you had a job, and there were cuts, there were budget cuts, and you were uncertain about your job. Okay, you didn't know if you had a job in the next week, tomorrow. You don't know. Okay. Fighting your fear, okay, in this instance, is worrying so much about how can I control it? How can I make sure that my job is stable? How can I do it? What can I do about it? Thinking of loads of different ways, panic. Okay, what can I do? What can I do? What can I do? Alarm bells. That is when we fight the problem, okay, and we attempt to control uncertainty. In this instance, the courageous thing to do would be to go, unfortunately, I don't know my job situation. Unfortunately, I don't know. My employment hangs in the balance. If I want to be okay, I have to be prepared for either way. I have to make arrangements that if I lose my job, that's okay. And if I keep it, that's okay as well. Yeah, I have to be okay with the uncertainty. That is courage. In the face of sheer adversity, your income, your livelihood, to be stoic and calm That's what you need to have, okay? Because a calm mind would probably make sure you probably end up with a job because they employed you because you were calm, yeah? If you were so super worried, they'd be like, I don't need somebody with that much chaos in their mind, yeah? Paradoxical. In the same vein, then, when we run away from something, the courageous thing to do is to seek it out, okay? So like I said about social anxiety, unfortunately, okay, baby steps, but unfortunately, the only way to tackle social anxiety is by talking to people, yeah? Eventually, to the point where you probably should stand up on a stage and sing. That should be a goal in life, to be so free of social anxiety that you could talk to anyone, you could go anywhere, you could do anything, yeah? But your goal right now should probably just be like, send a text to somebody you care about, because baby steps, yeah? But facing your fear, the absolute worst thing you could think of is probably your best goal to make your life the best thing ever. Yeah, the thing that you are super, super scared of, if you could conquer it, you could conquer anything, yeah? So when we run away from social interaction, that keeps us stuck and it keeps us fearful. We move towards it little by little. We come out of our shell, we build ourselves, you know, it just takes time and patience and love, self-love. So to just recap, I hope you've watched the whole thing. I know it's probably been a long one. To recap, we understand that fear is damaging physically to us. We understand that when we're cave people, we needed fear to survive. We no longer need fear to survive. We can therefore use it as a tool to benefit our lives by reimagining what fear means to us, okay? We can only face our fears with courage, and we can only build courage by facing our fears. Our lives would drastically improve if we learnt to face our fears properly. I really hope this helps, okay? I understand that it's taken me probably about 5-6 attempts to record this video, I'm not gonna lie. But I think this is the one, hopefully. If you've enjoyed, if it's helped, if you like me, if you've made it this far, all right, please leave a comment, give me a like, subscribe, do what you gotta do. I just really hope, I really do hope I've helped you a little bit, okay? And obviously, I will be here in the future to give you more advice, you know? But anyway, I love you all. I do what I do because I love myself, and therefore, I love all of you. Yeah? Anyway, see you later.